हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट न्यू टॉपिक चैप्टर नंबर 5 दैट इज डाटा हैंडलिंग। इन दिस वीडियो वी इंट्रोड्यूस द चैप्टर एंड डिस्कस द टॉपिक ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। फर्स्ट वी टॉक अबाउट व्हाट इज डाटा। द इंफॉर्मेशन collected of all the observation in numerical figure that is called data. Data is usually collected in the content of the situation that we want to study. For example, a teacher may like to know the average height of the student in her class. To find this, she will write the height of all the students in her class. Then she organized the data in the systematic manner. Then she interpret it accordingly. Sometime data is represent graphically to give a clear idea of what it represent. In earlier classes you already learned the different types of graph. First, we talk about pictograph. It is clear from its name, picto. Picto means pictorial in picture form. Pictorial representation of the data using symbol. And first, here one car is equal to 100 cars. Means one symbol stand for the 100 cars. In July month, 1, 2 and half means 250. One car shows 100 cars. Second car shows 100 cars, and this is half given. It denotes 1/100 means 250 cars in July month. August month, 1, 2, 3 means 300 cars. In September month, 1, 2, 3, 4 means if each car equal to 100, it means 4 cars equal to 4 into 100, that is 400. Students, next topic is bar graph. A display of the information using bar of the information with their heights being proportional to the respective values. For example, here data given academic year and number of students of 8th class. In this side, 2003, 4, 5, 6 and 7 year academic record, and this side number of students given. Bar heights give the quantity for each category. Bars are the equal width and equal gaps in between. These gaps, equal gaps and equal width. Width this one and equal gaps this one. And next we talk about double bar graph. A bar graph showing two sets of data stimulatively. It is a useful for the comparison of the data. If subject marks given and we are comparing the marks of 2 years, like 2005 and 6 and 6 and 7 here. This represent the marks of 2005 and 6, and this dark graph shows marks of 2006 and 7. Here marks obtained by a students like 10, 20, 30, 40, 50, 60, 70, 80. And here this side mathematics, social science, English, Hindi are given. This is called a double bar graph. In this only comparison of the data, and it shows the uniform representation of the marks. After double graph, next topic is organizing data. Organizing data. Data available to us in unorganized form called a raw data. When data not in a particular form, unorganized given without any sequence given, that is called raw data. Like in your class, different subject, arts, math, science, English, mathematics, arts, means different topic, unorganized way they given. How we organize that subject? Like first, with the help of tally or frequency, we can organize art subject. If here seven times come, then we use tally marks. Tally marks always represent for one, tally one, for two, tally two, for three, tally three, four, tally four, and if five, then four tallies, then fifth is cross. Six, one, two, three, four, five, then start again six. In this way, we use our tallies. Here, art subject seven times, then we will write in this form. Mathematics come five times, then we can write this form. Science subject six times, then fifth cross and six, next one. English four times, we use four tallies. And here frequency. Frequency means number of students here in counting. That is called a frequency. Frequency gives a number of times that in a particular entry occurs. Students, in next video we discuss group data, pie chart. We will cover that pending topics. For this video, this is sufficient, and you have to listen carefully and understand what I want to discuss or share with you. Thank you, beta.